What's up, guys? So in this video, we're going to start inserting some images, which will really start to make our website look legit. Right now, you'll notice I changed the colors. I like to change my colors up quite a bit. And so now I'm going with the purple and teal theme. That's because the images that I'm inserting will look better with these colors. So first, let's just do a quick review about the importance of file structure. So I'm going to open up my file structure here on the left, get into my Aptana workspace or wherever your folder is for your website. Mine, the folder's called Hello World. And make sure that you create a folder called Images. If you don't have one, create it. You're not going to want all your files just crammed in this folder. You're going to want some structure. So what I did is I added the Images folder and I threw some images in there for us to play with in this video. So whenever we build our links into the images, we're going to use relative links that will point to this folder and pull the images from that folder. Okay, so enough said about that. Let's play with some images. I'm going to scroll down here, and I am going to first put in my YouTube banner instead of the Hello World text at the top. So that's going to be down here in the HTML where it says Hello World. I am just going to delete that out. And then to insert an image, we are going to use the image attribute with src for source. And this is where we're going to put the path to our image. So I'm going to put images, because that's the name of the folder it's in. And then this program, it's already showing me a list of the images in there. I want Mel's banner.png. And then make sure it's closed out with a quote. Now, it's always important to add alt text or alternative text to your images in the event it doesn't load or someone's viewing it with a screen reader. So I'm going to put Melody's YouTube banner. And you're just going to put the description of the image. Be sure not to say image of or picture. Just describe what the picture is showing without the use of the words image or picture. And then we could also put a height or width. I'm going to, let's see. I'm going to put in a width. Let's try 625 and then a height. Not nearly that much. Let's try 85. See what that looks like. We might need to play with it. And then let's go ahead and go up here. Oh, before we do anything, before we go look, let's go up to our CSS, and in our reset styles, let's add image. So that would be here, IMG, comma, so that we can have those default border padding and margins. Okay, now let's save it, and let's run it. Let's see what it looks like. Okay, so I know I obviously need to play with the padding a bit. That's why I have all this space around it. And as far as the size, the height could be a little bit higher. So if I go down here to where the image is with the height, let's go ahead and put, let's go 95. And now with the height of 95, before we go and refresh and check it out again, I'm going to go up here to the image itself, which is in the heading. And I am going to add a height of 95 pixels so that the height matches the height of the picture. Of course, the navigation itself has a little bit of a margin, so we're going to see a little bit of a gap, but not nearly as much as we did before. And the reason why we don't put px is because this is automatically pixels. So when you put numbers in, it knows that it's the pixel size for images. So let's save this and go in and refresh. Much better. Okay, so nice and clean. Would I use this banner for a banner on my website? Not necessarily. The YouTube banner has different specifications. As a perfectionist as I am, I would probably make this go all the way to the sides and go in Photoshop and actually edit the image itself. But there you go. We've got our banner. Now let's go ahead and add a background image, which is slightly different. You notice that to insert images, we did it in the HTML. and then we styled it using CSS. To insert background images, we only use CSS. So let's go here and find my article section. Here we go. And I am going to add a background image this time. Now, background images, the best images to use for backgrounds would be called seamless images. You can go online and look for free seamless images. There's a bunch out there. But seamless just means that it can be tiled and repeat and you wouldn't be able to tell. So it's a repeating pattern, a seamless pattern. So I'm going to use one of those. And then to add a background image, we do background. And then we do a colon. And then we type in the word URL. A parenthesis, and then this is where we're going to put the name of our image in quotes. So this is images, and this time I'm going to use a seamless image I have called geometric.png, and then don't forget this semicolon at the end there for the rule. And then before we save, since we have two backgrounds here now, we need to change this background color just to the shortcut or shorthand rule background. By having this here at the bottom, very important, this rule takes precedent. It will look at the bottom first. So in this declaration, it will look at this one. If it's unable to load, then it will look at this one. So if it can't load the background, it will keep a background of white. So important to keep both of those. Let's go ahead and save it and see what it looks like. And there you go, that's one example. A little busy for my taste. Let's try a different one. So then I would just go in here, and in the images folder, I also have another one. Let's go here. Let's try weave. I think I'm gonna like that better. And that one is a JPEG, I believe. So let's save that. And you can use pings, JPEGs, GIFs. Just remember the image type does impact the download type. And there you go. So now we have a background here. Now notice it kept this square white. And that's because the article div itself, the container that the paragraph is wrapped in, still has a background color of white. So the article, which is this bigger box here, has the background, and then the container, the div, has the background of white. If I wanted them both to be the same, then I would go ahead and put that background image in here too, but then you couldn't read the text. I think this is perfect. And since it was applied to the article, you'll notice we don't see it past the footer. So there you go, we inserted two images, a background image and a banner image. In our next video, we're going to add a figure image and a caption, so stay tuned and I will see you next time.